Welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. With me in the studio today is Vered Caplan from Orgenesis. Vered, always great to see you.
Great to see you. I'm really glad I've had this chance to come in and do a little bit of updating. A lot has been going on, and I'm happy to kind of put it in perspective.
You've been kind of traveling all over the world. Orgenesis has done a lot of recent deals, involved in so many different innovations. What has been the latest since we last spoke a few weeks ago?
So, you know, some of the exciting developments have actually been around our capability to make cells, right? We were very good at processing cells. And one of our goals is to process these cells, especially the ones that we're using, for instance, the liver cells, mm-hmm. in what we call closed systems, where they're actually in a very protected environment. And allows us, it's actually what it can enable, this closed manufacturing or closed processing, as we call it. Mm-hmm. It allows you to actually make this at a lower cost in a, you know, in a more flexible setting, so you can make it in different locations. And we've really optimized this capability of ours. And just to remind you, we are making liver cells because we use them as a base for our diabetic targeting therapy. Mm-hmm. We re-educate the liver cells epigenetically so they produce insulin in a glucose-sensitive manner. Mm-hmm. But as we've been going through this and really developed a technology and the system that allows us to make these cells, we're thinking, you know, why not collaborate with other people who could use this capability and try to find additional applications and develop the additional platforms and systems which will allow us to make other products.
And you're referring to your partnership now with Digilab. Walk me through that partnership.
Yes, and those are examples as well. But let's look at Digilab. What is the essence of this partnership? They have really amazing technology for printing cells. And what does printing cells allow you to do? It actually allows you to make tissues, right? Mm-hmm. And their uniqueness and their capability is actually to take these cells and very, very gently manipulate them, right? Mm-hmm. You don't want to harm, you don't want to change their characteristics. And they also have unique fluid, almost like a glue, that allows them to put together several types of cells and actually make almost a physiological tissue. Mm-hmm. You can take cells that are liver cells, for example, and add to them MSC cells or maybe the basis for a vascular structure. This is very exciting, right? And that capability to actually build out tissues in an efficient manner. So our partnership is, first of all, an R&D joint development and how we take the capability of printing cells and incorporate it into a closed platform that can be used at point of care. And again, that's a journey we can do together because we have the capability of characterizing these cells. And then, together working with them, we can actually develop this closed system.
So will Orgenesis own that new cell printer system?
Well, it's not a cell printer system, it's a component out of that, right? Mm-hmm. It's a whole process, and it will allow us to make then these specific tissues at any location that is optimal. Mm. And whether it's and that's our goal, to make this as a closed unit, which will allow very high quality manufacturing, you could even say, or processing of these tissues.
Moving on from 3D printing to exosome-related technologies, that's another deal that you've been working on recently that you have announced with ExcellaBio. Mm-hmm. Walk me through this deal and why it's so important.
So, you know, exosomes technology is actually, it can be made out of the cellular membranes or structures, and it's actually a drug delivery. It's a way to utilize the cells' unique capabilities without actually using the cells themselves. Mm-hmm. So you actually make these exosomes out of the cellular structures. Now, Dr. Sabina Glossman, she's an incredible expert in this field. And by the way, she has a lot of prestige because she's actually brought to market other biotech products. And she's really worked, and she's not only a researcher, she's very applicable. She knows how to make products, okay? And that's a different thing. Mm-hmm. So under her management, we feel very comfortable working together and utilizing our, again, cell processing capabilities in our specific cellular structures that we work with, and utilizing her technologies and her capabilities, her company's capabilities, to actually utilize these cellular bases as a platform to make additional applications, drugs, therapies that utilize the extracts from these cells.
Specifically, what kind of commercial applications do you hope to create?
So, you know, I think one of the first applications we've been looking at is using these exosomes as a basis for administering different drugs or different active materials into the skin for dermatology applications. Okay, that's an example. There's a few others, but I think that's a very practical one. And again, if you have a cell that can be utilized to develop, and again, that capability, if you want to deliver, for instance, a drug to the liver, let's use exosomes we've made as a basis from that, right? Mm-hmm. So it's almost utilizing the natural environment that knows how to deliver a substance to the cell to utilize it for drug development.
Well, it seems like you've been very busy. What's the next deal that we can expect coming from Orgenesis?
Well, you know, we're really putting a focus now on working on our, as I said, closed systems and trying to put them together and actually allowing this unique processing to do. And we're looking at ways we can optimize that. So that's kind of where our focus is today. I mean, our goal is, of course, developing therapies is great, but we want to lower the cost. We want to make sure these therapies are available to everyone. And that's the whole challenge when you talk about cell and gene therapies, right? How do you make them accessible? How do you process them? How do you make them available at every place that people need them?
Well, always interesting to have you in studio, Vered. Thank you so much for being with me here today.
Thank you. I really appreciate the questions, and thank you for following us so closely.